More and more GPs are saying that they should be wearing protective equipment when dealing with all patients. The official advice is that PPE should only be worn if people being treated have suspected symptoms or they've actually been diagnosed with coronavirus. This programme has learned that those guidelines are about to be updated. We can talk to Dr. Faye Kirkland, a BBC reporter, and herself a GP. So, Faye, give us a sense of what fellow GPs have been saying to you.
Well, the current advice, as you say, from health authorities is to wear personal protective equipment, so masks, gloves and a plastic apron, if patients have suspected symptoms or have been diagnosed with the coronavirus. But there is increasing disquiet. Whilst a lot of patients in general practice can be cared for on the phone, some will still need to be seen. Now, two GPs I've spoken to say that they feel they've got coronavirus symptoms and believe they contracted it while seeing patients at their surgeries. One of them treated a man with a head injury who turned up outside her North London practice. She says he appeared to be intoxicated and was bleeding from his head. Now, importantly, he had no cough and no fever, so she didn't wear her protective equipment or PPE, as he just didn't meet the criteria. He then tested positive in hospital for the coronavirus, and she now has symptoms. I spoke to Ruth Rankine, the Director of Primary Care, NHS Confederation, and she told me that many frontline staff are really, really scared. She said when they go in and see patients, even though they might not be displaying symptoms, they may still have the virus, and she's seeing an increasing number of primary care workforce going off sick.
So why might the guidance change now?
Well, there has been increasing calls for clarity. The documents seen by the BBC suggest that the guidance on protective equipment is expected to be updated in the next 2 days, both for hospital and GP health workers. On Wednesday, the Royal College of GPs wrote to Matt Hancock to clarify if GPs should now wear this protective equipment all the time. Now, the documents also reveal that NHS supply chain, which has been sending out the equipment, hasn't been able to manage the delivery of the PPE, and another NHS body is now responsible. The Prime Minister said on Wednesday that he'd been assured that stocks of PPE were on the way to NHS staff, but the Department of Health has not yet commented on if this guidance will be updated.
Dr. Faye Kirkland, thank you.